Meanwhile, New Hampshire Senator Kelly Ayotte is back from leading a delegation to the Ukraine, as well as stops in Afghanistan and Israel. But Russian aggression is what is on the minds of a lot of people in Washington, and how far the U.S. should go in defending that region. Her trip to Ukraine may have centered on the tension built by the Russian occupation of the Crimean Peninsula. But Senator Ayotte also saw firsthand that Vladimir Putin's plans may be expanding.
While we were there, they arrested three Russian armed agents in eastern Ukraine. Essentially, they were armed, they had money, and what they were trying to do is stir things up in eastern Ukraine.
During a packed interview on Close Up airing this Sunday, Ayotte said she would not support U.S. boots on the ground to challenge Russian forces, but she did call for tougher sanctions.
Putin only understands strength. He's a former KGB colonel. I've called him sort of the schoolyard bully.
On the domestic front, the Republican senator addressed what she says the Homeland Security Director sees as a national threat, heroin.
I think nationally there needs to be better coordination and focusing of resources on this horrible epidemic that's not just impacting New Hampshire, it is really impacting so many states in the nation.
And in the Senate race involving incumbent Democrat Jeanne Shaheen, Kelly Ayotte calls Scott Brown's emergence an exciting one, going so far as to defend the former Massachusetts senator's New Hampshire pedigree.
With regard to Scott, I mean, he was born at the Portsmouth Naval Shipyard. He does have his family, some strong ties to New Hampshire. And so we'll know he'll go out and talk to one voter at a time.
You can see our entire interview with Senator Kelly Ayotte on Close Up this Sunday at 10 o'clock. I'm also going to sit down with the Assistant Secretary of State, Rick Barton. He was in New Hampshire this week to talk about global security.